Jonathan Paula presents Game Time. Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome back to my Watch Dogs Let's Play on the PlayStation 3. Let's pick up where we left off, controlling Aiden Pearce, an elite hacker in the city of Chicago.
You got a problem. Survivor from the stadium. If that guy talks, he'll ID you.
Survivor? How did that happen?
I'm guessing he didn't die. Relax, I got a plan. Meet me at Gorman Heights on the rooftop.
You got it. Jody, or Jordy, or Jordy LaForge, whatever the fuck your name is. Yeah, and I'm on one, you shitheel. We have roads for a reason. Fuck, you're in the middle of one. What a fucking asshole. How do I check into this place? Oh, here we go. I have to be on foot. Retrieving items, St. Joseph Cemetery. Take five. Five check-ins down. Many more to go. Spot history. Among the tombstones of honest, hard-working men and women, there is one gravesite in the cemetery that is particularly notable. Dug into the cemetery's mountain, bearing a sculpture of his likeness, is the Grand Tomb of Finnegan Jones, Chicago's most popular Lincoln impersonator. Upon his death, Jones received a state funeral attended by over 1,000 adoring fans. 36 check. Dude, you guys gotta get a life. Who's playing Watch Dogs? That means you played for at least 36 hours, and the game's only been out for 1 week. At the date of my recording, by the way. So, 36 hours divided by 7, that's at least 5 or 6 hours a day. And all of that time you spent at the cemetery, apparently. Like, you weren't exploring the rest of Chicago. You were here at the cemetery. Well, I feel like that's... I worry for some of these people.
That's got it.
I worry for some of the people that play video games that religiously. Like, I was talking to some guy on Reddit like a week ago who was like level 630 on Grand Theft Auto 5 online, and he assures me he did so legitimately without any hacking or griefing. And he's like, oh yeah, you know, I just love the game, I'm on all the time, yada yada yada. And apparently he logged something like 46 total days of playtime. And this game did come out in September, but even so, that's, what, like 9-10 months ago? You do the math, that works out to him playing the game like 7 hours every single day since it came out. Like, do you people not have fucking lives or a job? I would love to sit inside and play a video game 8 hours every single day for 10 straight months. Actually, you know what, I wouldn't love that, because I feel like that would just make me really depressed. Like, I would want to go out and, like, spend time with my wife or my friends, or watch a movie, or, like, eat dinner at a restaurant. This guy's playing, like, what do you do for a living that affords you the opportunity to play video games 10 hours every single day? That is, it's nuts. It really is, and it's concerning to me, as I would say, a generally well-adjusted individual, that people like that exist, that you can just fucking play video games that much. I would get bored of it. I would want to play another game. I would want to do other forms of entertainment. Like, say I have 8 hours of free time every day. That's perfectly reasonable. You have a full-time job, you get home from work, you commute, whatever, you change, you relax, you have dinner, you still might have 8 hours of free time every single day. But to only spend it on one game every day, nonstop, that is a foreign concept to me. I like to divide my time up amongst friends, and TV, and video games, and interneting, and then every now and then, you know, play Grand Theft Auto. But, like, wow, Fortnite, I know, that's definitely not the norm, so I think I can at least take solace in the fact that this individual is not the average. But for real, like, what? 46 days of game time? I've never put that much time into any single game ever. Including StarCraft, which I think is probably the one I've played the most out of all the games I've ever played. That and, I think, Counter-Strike. I used to log a lot of Counter-Strike hours. But, damn. What do you even do on Grand Theft Auto Online? Like, I feel like those races will get boring.
Jordy can be a pain to work with. He's the devil I know.
That's the end of my rant. Okay, back to story mode.
I might be hunting him down. Or vice versa. But if he says we got a problem, I need to take it as a massive understatement.
Climb to meet Jordy on
the survivor ID me.
Patio deck.
Everything's gonna spiral out of control.
Yeah. Survivor's guilt, all that shit, right?
Oh, my friends died, so I have to honor their memory by reporting them.
I just realized my Don Knotts impression is more of a Jimmy Stewart impression, but alright, I think both will do. You gonna get that survivor? I'll climb up there and pull him down for you, Mary. Alright, what do we get? Oh, that was easy. I thought I was gonna do some, like, intense hacking, but I just climbed straight up like a ladder. If there's anything Aiden Pearce can do, it's climb a ladder.
Oh, fuck. Jordy, who are they?
My dinner guests.
Well, they live here.
What happened?
Well, security in these buildings is pretty tight. So, people like this feel nice and secure living way up here. I mean, these people just had a simple chain lock on their door. I guess they want to have a good look at the pizza guy before they open it all the way.
All right, fine, sure. So, about this problem.
Well, that's why I brought the bolt cutters. He opens the door this much, there's a chain right there, I slip him in and snip, and guess what? It's not the pizza guy.
Jordy, the problem, let's deal with it.
I like this guy.
We are dealing with it. We're in the midst of solutions here, Pearce. You don't appreciate what I do for you. You don't realize how much I take care of you, do you?
Really?
Yeah.
Well, do me a favor, let's get on with it. How much time do we have?
Not as much as we need. Oh, you remember the stiff from the stadium? He's not so stiff anymore. The cops got him in Chicago lockup, and oh, he's about to walk into an interrogation and point a finger right at you.
Don't point at me. I don't like it. Only Harrison Ford gets the point.
How did that happen?
Kick me when I'm down. Look at the view.
See, you have a rifle there.
Call went out this morning. Somebody is paying buku bucks to grab this clown and make him talk. And one of those guys is running the assignment.
Well, it seems like me and him need to have a little chat.
Yeah, but this time, don't do that empty gun thing. Poor Maurice pissed himself after your last show.
Don't worry about my methods. You know how to use that thing?
Just get your ass down there, I got you covered. And don't kill the boss this time. You kinda need him.
You think?
Climb to me, Jordy. Infiltrate the rail yard. Oh, whoops. Oh, that's okay. I didn't fall all the way down. I can get in via the water. Climb up that way. Oh, this looks like a big undertaking. Well, let's begin.
Let's make this quick, okay? My balcony hosts are moaning, and that stuff gives me migraines. I get a migraine, Pearce. I am useless to you.
You think you're the only one who wants this quick?
How should I know what you want?
Not big on empathy, are you?
Not particularly.
What's up with this fixer contract? What are they looking for?
You. Somebody wants the vigilante big time. They're about to fake a prisoner transfer to bust out the one witness who can ID you. I've never seen them gather up this kind of manpower, though.
They know I'll try and stop them. Listen, the witness knows my face. If the fixers reach him, if my name gets out there, they'll come after my family.
The F word. You're too sentimental, Pearce. That's a weakness. Somebody's gonna play that against you someday. I'll cover you where I can, but I can't see everybody. All right, let's do this. Nice try, but I can see you.
Where am I looking? Where am I? I don't even know where I am. Okay, well, there. Our stupid friend's over on the building. Jordy LaForge. Now, originally, I thought the informant guy that we were supposed to take out was the guy he hogtied in the building, but he took over that apartment just for the vantage point. Now, I need to reach way over there. Alright, so this is... because I have to actually get in here, I think. Like, that's the tricky part. Now, do I just want to kill everybody, or do I want to sneak in? I want to try to sneak in. Alright, so I unlocked... I don't fucking know. Oh, I unlocked a door over there, so that's gonna be helpful. For the guy involved in an affair. Yeah, yeah, great. I'm out of range. Damn it! Damn it, Chloe! Who's looking my way? Is see a number of individuals. Okay, now this guy's moving. He's on to move. This looks like a big block of wood in his way, though. Throw low or distract enemies to receive sniper support. I don't know that I need the sniper support just yet, but I'll keep you in mind, Chief. Can I get right over there? Maybe he didn't see me. All right. I'm doing all right. I'm almost where I need to be.
Careful, Pearce. One of them's getting brave.
I hear you, mate. I can sneak up on these bad boys.
But I can see you.
Yeah, I want you to see me. That's the whole point of support, you schmuck. Oh, he almost saw me. I can do this. I can do this without getting seen.
Yeah, I see you, pal.
Shit!
Shit! I know that guy.
Which one?
I always forget his name. The guy with the ears.
Shit! This noise.
What?
That was his name, Douglas.
Well, I didn't even have to kill anybody outside. I just run right to it. I almost had it without killing anybody. Almost had it.
Hold on. Stop.
Who's assigned to the prison job?
What? Man, I don't know what you're talking about.
Lance Brenner. As a family.
What are you doing?
I'm asking how your family is. Looks like you got two lives going at once. Family man. And the kids are gonna be in college soon. It's pricey for a union rep.
Fuck you.
Yeah, and there's also the second life. Ghost accounts with a lot of money in them.
Hey. How could someone support two families?
Do you know that your name is tied to a whole bunch of cold cases? I bet the cops would love a chat.
Okay, hold on. You want a piece of the cash? I can cut you in.
You're wasting my time.
All right! Fuck. Prison job. It's Angelo Tucci. He's running a convoy. It's too late. You'll never find him.
Who says I want him? Bet he's got a family in town.
Why do you want his family? The fuck is wrong with you?
Lots of things. At least according to the psychiatrist.
I wouldn't know when to begin.
Use the profiler to find and hack CTOS boxes.
More fixtures incoming.
How bad?
Remember Kinderhook?
Shit.
I don't remember Kinderhook. What's a Kinderhook? Alright, pause game. I have 3 points. Can I take out a helicopter with one of them? Blackout. IED. Combat. Improved focus. Oh, it was a hacking skill, wasn't it? This one. Disable helicopter for 15 seconds. I have a feeling I'm gonna need that. Everything else is redlined. Suck on that! Gotta run the fuck right out of this place. Y'all ain't gonna stop me! What you gonna do? What you gonna do? I'm in a dead end. You're gonna kill me is what's gonna happen. I like them apples, huh? Oh! Oh, right in the fucking gut. Take that. Damn it. I need a way out of here. Jordy LaForge, help me out! Go back the way I came.
Always gotta do things the hard way, huh?
I'll do things the way I want.
Get moving. I'll finish up here.
What do you gotta finish up? Leave him alive. Nobody needs to die tonight. That's Batman's one rule. No killing. Alright, climb up that water. Yo!
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Come on, Aiden. They don't even have, like, a... They're not even close to tracking you. Where am I? Well, I'm not... Oh, okay. Not on the right platform. It happens. Am I good to escape yet? Like, at what point does, like, the escape happen? Like, I've been running with the intense, dramatic music for quite a bit of time here. Top on the bike. Blow this popsicle stand. Am I out yet? At what point do I escape the radiation zone here? Have I sufficiently escaped? I don't understand. Am I supposed to be doing something? It said kill all fixers or escape. I feel like I've sufficiently escaped. I feel like I'm a city away from where the crime happened. But my wanted level is like maxed out red slashy lines, whatever that means. And I thought I was getting the hang of this game, and then it's like, whoop! Turns out everything we taught you was not true. It's all a bunch of malarkey. Oh, shit! Holy shit! Da 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 da. Oh, did I die? Did I die just now? Nope. I probably should have, but I didn't. Hey, what's up? Hey, what's up? You didn't see me drive through the air on a bike. I don't know what I'm supposed to do right now. Maybe if I head to like a fucking hideout? Let's head to a fucking hideout. Maybe that's the only way to get this thing off of me. I just love doing the... Every time I drive over a bridge, I'm gonna do that. Just let you know what's coming up. Oh, the brakes on these things are not very good.
What the fuck, man?
Yeah, man. There's my hideout. Escape your pursuers. I thought I did. What the fuck is wrong with this? Do I have to go back there and kill them all? Is that the only way I'm going to be able to finish this mission? It says I escape is an option. And yet very clearly that's not the case. Because I've escaped. And they're still hunting for me. Guess I'll go back to the train yard and just fucking open fire. Because this mission doesn't seem like it's going to end any other way. This is weird. I hope I'm not misunderstanding this. Because it seems pretty self-explanatory. Kill all the dudes or escape. And I thought I did escape. But apparently their swath of coverage is the entire map. So you can never escape. Oh, you're fine, Aiden. Get up! Get up! Get up! There's no time for dicking around on the fucking asphalt. Alright, here we go. The adventures of Aiden Pearce continue. Oh, that's no good. Wow, I didn't fall off. Good for you, good for you. This thing's chewing out black smoke. That's good for it, right? That means it's gonna, like, go faster. That's the nitrous kicking in, that's what that is. Just another wonderful day in the neighborhood. A wonderful day to be a neighbor. Won't you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor? I would not want to be Aiden Pearce's neighbor, because that almost assuredly means he would be spying on you when you take a shower. Because you know, Aiden is definitely into that sort of thing. You can tell. Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm back to kill everybody. Profiler enabled. Hey, stop it. I'm trying to kill you all. Oh, I didn't want to do that. Now I have no cover. Damn it. Fucking exposed. Damn it. The fuck am I doing? What am I on right now? Piece of shit. Don't let him escape. Something like that. Fucking headshots. Come on. You want a piece of this? Stop shooting me! Have left. Who's left in this place? God. I just want this mission to be over. Come on, let's go. I wanted to leave you guys alive. All right? That was my strategy. But no. You wanted to get murdered. Neutralized. Jerk. To the fucking balls. So what's the deal? Have I not killed everybody at this point?
Keep searching. We had them.
Who am I searching for? What is this? I don't even. Haha. Do I have to take the helicopter down? Is that what this is about?
Jesus, where the hell is he?
The hell is who? Oh, I did it. I don't know why it took so long for this thing to trigger, but looks like I finally did it. I'll take it, whatever. Unfortunately, that does it for this episode of Game Time. Please stay tuned for the next installment of my Watch Dogs Let's Play, where we continue the adventures of Aiden Pearce here in Chicago. But if you prefer not to wait, you can watch the next video right now by clicking the playlist link in the description. As always, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.